In 1926, Pope Pius XI instituted a mission Sunday to pray, offer fraternal and concrete help to support the mission. This is usually celebrated on the next to last Sunday of October. Today, we recommit ourselves to our common vocation to be missionaries through baptism. God is the one who calls, invites, and initiates. And if calling is proper to God, then response is proper to man. This response is a fundamental and radical decision which we have all made during baptism. Today, Pope Francis is asking us to pray for all missionaries and contribute our quota to the work of evangelization. Pope Francis is inviting us to share the love with one another, especially during this pandemic. Since God has created us out of love and has been so faithful to us despite our unfaithfulness and wretchedness, we cannot help but proclaim and share what we have seen and heard. It is improper for us to bury the gifts we have been given, because everyone needs to hear the good news that they are loved and faithful. He went further to explain how the apostles experienced the love of God through Jesus Christ. He preached the gospel and bore witness to Christ, even in the face of persecution and rejection. My dear brothers and sisters, many of us believe that to be a missionary is a call reserved to super spiritual or extraordinary people. This is not true, because by the virtue of our baptism, we have been given a share in this task to proclaim the goodness of hope to the world. We are not alone, just as the disciples were not alone. Behold, I am with you, even to the end of the world. Matthew 28, verse 20. We are called today to celebrate, participate, pray and donate generously to support the mission of the church. For we are all missionaries. Some give to the mission by going, some give to the mission by giving. About 4 days ago, I met a young man in a place, and he told me, "Father, I love men of God, and I respect them so well." And he asked, "Do you know a priest like this?" I told him, "Yes." He said that priest was my classmate. I really wanted to be a priest, but my mother did not allow me. In other words, he was telling me, I wanted to give to the mission by going, but my mother did not allow me. Now, dear brothers and sisters, for this young man, all hope is not lost, because we become good news to the world by what we are or by what we give. It does not really matter whether you give to the mission by going or you give to the mission by giving. What matters is our faithfulness. And today we are called to ask ourselves, have I been faithful to the mission of Christ? What have I done with my baptism? What are the rules or the promises I made during my baptism? My dear brothers and sisters, so many of us have abandoned the gospel mission because of the worldly and the empty show in the world. We have fallen into the attractions and distractions in the world. We have embraced the noise from the flesh and the noise from materialism. Today we are reminded to return to the mission field. Embrace the mission and tell the Lord's wonders among all the peoples. Remember that those who keep to God's covenants of the Great Commission will be brought to the holy mountain of God. Just as the first reading tells us. And the second reading assures us that no one who believes and accepts the mission of Christ will be put to shame. May the Lord give us the grace to respond appropriately to the mission we have been given. Through Christ, amen.